No, you haven't reached a horror movie. You are still in our course. We are visiting today the National Collections at the Tel Aviv Natural History Museum. Indeed, after watching so much wildlife in Africa and elsewhere, it is a bit shocking to see all these stuffed animals. I asked Dr. Amos Belmaker, the curator of the bird collection, who is hosting us here, about the importance of such a collection.
The idea of having a scientific collection like this is to get a kind of a still image of the biodiversity in space and time. And future researchers can then go back and study these specimens and learn how animals change with time, with different human influences, or whatever other questions that come into their minds.
I'm standing next to the famous Schmitz collection. Father Ernst Schmitz was a Catholic monk and an enthusiastic zoologist. Schmitz lived in Jerusalem between 1908 and 1914 and established the first natural history museum. The whereabouts of this collection was unknown for many years until Professor Yossi Leshem rediscovered it in 1978. This collection features many specimens that were collected by or for Schmitz and that represent the local fauna present at the beginning of the 20th century. Sadly, many of the species of large vertebrates, such as the cheetah, leopard, lammergeier, and crocodile represented in the collection, have gone extinct in Israel since then. In the winter of 1983, I hiked with my girlfriend in the Judean desert. Next to one of the very few permanent springs called En Amer, the leopard spring, we were surprised by two leopards. Since then, sightings of leopards have become exceedingly rare, and leopards are now believed to have gone extinct in Israel.
Human activity has become, especially since the advent of the Industrial Revolution, the major factor influencing our environment. So much so that our era is now called the Anthropocene, the human era. We have learned about the five major extinctions that affected life since the Cambrian explosion. In recent years, we are sadly witnessing more and more species becoming extinct due to human activity, due to hunting and fishing, due to the environmental degradation, due to poisoning, and due to the introduction of invasive species. The World Wildlife Fund reported that in the last 50 years, the populations of terrestrial vertebrates declined by 60%. This horrifying fact shows that the rate of extinction during the Anthropocene is fast approaching that of a mass extinction event. The sixth such event since the Cambrian explosion. The report argues that it is still not too late to act to reverse this trend. To finish this chapter, we will now visit the Inter-University Institute for Marine Sciences in Eilat to learn about the coral reefs and their conservation.